We lived in the same small town outside of Pittsburgh, a little mill town. I knew who he was because he was a friend of a cousin of mine, but it wasn't till I got to the University of Pittsburgh. I happened to be selling raffle tickets for charity. I asked him if he would buy a ticket.
And I thought to myself, this is a cute girl. I'm gonna buy a ticket. And I'm going to ask her out. So I did ask her out for that weekend, and we went out, and we both had a good time. We got married in 1951. The secret of a long marriage is to fall in love with a special person that you really enjoy being with every day.
And also, I believe being considerate of each other helps a lot to keep it.
We think alike. We have similar values. We like the same music. You know, we go to concerts. We like the same movies and plays. I think that's a secret.
I first started to teach when I graduated, and then I left teaching to raise a family. And when our youngest went into first grade, I went back to teaching and taught for 16 more years.
I had a hardware store in downtown Pittsburgh, and I had been in that location for 35 years, and my father before that. And then one day, the city said that PPG wanted to build their tower, and they were gonna take the property through eminent domain, and there was nothing I could do about it. And we fought through the courts for about 15 months, so we finally were able to prevail. I continued in my business until I retired when I was about 65 years old.
He always said, we have to take the chance. We can't look at ourselves in the mirror if we don't fight them. And nobody expected us to win, and he did. We moved 5 years ago to New Jersey because our daughter-in-law died and left our son with three little children, and we thought we should be closer. We lived 3 years in Englewood, and then we decided we'd like to live in a senior facility, so we moved here.
You know, they say in real estate, location, location, location. Well, this is it. It's really excellent for us.
The bus stop is across the street in 25 minutes. We're at 42nd Street in Manhattan, and we can go to the museums, go to plays. It's just a perfect for us. I do cook one day a week because I have my son and grandchildren for dinner. We have a full kitchen, room for a dining room table to sit around, and I enjoy having them over.
When you're older especially, instead of just living in an apartment by yourself, although we have each other, when you're here, we go down for breakfast in the morning, and there's 40, 50 people there, and everybody says hello, good morning. It's just very pleasant, so we really, really enjoy it. We're lucky to be here.